Welcome back to my channel. My name still remains Kenny. You're welcome. If you're new here, if you're just finding this channel, oh my god, like, what have you been waiting for? Please join us. You're welcome. So if you're just saying this, you're welcome. My name is Kenny and I film on lifestyle challenges and spirituality all the way from Ogun State right here in Nigeria. You're welcome. So today I want to be sharing with us my experience, like, as a student, my experience as a student right here in Nigeria institution. Like, how does it feel like? Oh my god. Ah, it was hell. So I'm going to be sharing with us also things, the facts or things that our parents or people will not tell us in general. People will not tell you. You know, now you're going to school as a student, you're going to school, you're just a new fresher. So you're going to school for the first time in your life. Things that people will not tell you. They will tell you that when you get there, don't worry, they will teach you. Ah! Oh god. The lessons they will not tell you. Like, from their own experience, the lesson they will, I'm going to be sharing with it with us today. So without much ado, just calm down, calm down. We're going to be in enjoy ourselves. So without much ado, let's just jump right in. You see the way I meet Conley. Well, back then in, was it not 2017, 18, when I got admitted, when I got admission, ah, oh my god, it was only once mommy followed me to school. It was only once. And then the remaining ones, it is only me. Like, the struggle you are going to go through, people are not going to tell you that you are going to go through the stress of walking from one hall to another. No. In fact, the admission stuff is so terrible. Like my school now, there's no shuttle that is going to be carrying us from one place to another. No. You will use your leg. You are going to use your leg. It's just that God has destined that I'm going to be fat. If not, I would have been so lean more than broom. Like, broom would have been fatter than me. A single broom, just one, it would have been fatter than me. So these are the experiences I had, the struggle. Like, we have to walk from one hall to another. We did registration, then we did screening. Now I'm in batch B. The thing was done batch by batches. So me, I fall on batch B because I didn't actually register for that school. I actually registered for another one. I actually registered for CDEP. Let me say CDEP. But some things came up and I couldn't make it to that CDEP again. It's not as if I didn't. My exam score, like everything I had, it's so okay, so good for it. But you know, we had some challenges that time, so I couldn't really go for it again. And I had to opt out of that one and opt in for the lower one. So in that school, my god, the name of this school is Federal College of Education Abeokuta in Ogun State. So see, if you don't there, you can, like, if you are not strong, you cannot survive. The race is for the, it's not for the sweet, it's for the strong. This time around, it's not for the sweet, it's for the strong. Like, I went through the trouble of Jesus. Me, that I'm always like, we always enter taxi, we enter car from home to school, then from school back home. It's not like before again, like everything has changed. I had to start trekking from one school. And if you see this school I'm talking about, oh my god, we are going to resume soon. I'm going to make sure I did a tour, a school tour or something like that. If you see this school, Jesus, like, nobody's going to tell you the struggles you are going to go through. Like, you have to walk. This one is not even about walking. You know, naturally, you know, you're going to trek. Sometimes, it's not even sometimes, virtually every time you trek. But the thing I see in our own is that we don't have shelter. Assuming we have just shot in our school, we would have helped a lot of students. We would have just been running and trekking at the same time. Jesus. So the good experience though, so it helped us to, like, become more smarter. If you are smart before, it helped you become more smarter. So that's the first one, the struggle. Like, okay, the second one is nobody's going to tell you, ta, babe, you have to wake up early. Cook, me that I love to sleep, Jesus. You have to wake up early, cook, bathe yourself, dress yourself, and start walking to the lecture hall. Like, no one is going to tell you that, like, no one is going to tell you the things that you need to do. She'll be telling at home. I'm just like, well, I have somebody that will do that. That's someone. But yeah, you're going to do it yourself. Like, if you don't cook, if you don't wake up to cook, you're on your own. Are you kidding me? Nobody's ready to give you his or her food. Okay, this girl. She's like, good girl. When everybody's struggling to get their food done, when they are struggling to prepare everything they need on time, you are just sleeping. Come on, you're on your own. And me, I'm the type that I don't like eating early. I don't really like eating early that much. I don't really like it. And let me see before I... Yes, I don't really like eating early that much. You know, I would just wake up. We have lectures by 7, and I would have woke up around 5:30. Depends on my roommate. I would have woke up around 5:30, 6, around that time. Sometimes 6. If I want to cook rice or whatever I want to cook, place it on the fire, went to bed, dress, be cooking. So we'll be doing everything together at the same time. Me, I'm not at home. But when I got to school, that was when I knew that, yes, this place I am on my own, nobody's going to like bring food to your table. If you don't cook it by yourself, you're on your own. So I'm going to be keeping all these facts. Maybe to some people who have gone to school, if you have your own too, please just drop it in the comment section. Like, drop it there. Let's just let it be fun. And for those people who are just getting admission, if you are seeing this video, don't get discouraged. Like, school is full of fun, it's full of struggle. Those are the lessons, those are the stories we tell at the end of the day. Those are the challenges we face. So back to the things I learned. And the third one is it the third one? Whatever. The next one is, nobody is going to tell you manage the money in your hand. I say, if you like, be spending it anyhow. Be spending it anyhow. Okay, now, if they have given you your, let me say, allowance for 2 weeks, and then within 3 days, you have spent your money finish. Oh my God. You're on your own. You know, some children have this parent that, so all of us, our parents are so blessed. Let me use that word. But some parents, they are disciplined to the extent that they have given you that money, spend it for 2 weeks. You now go and spend it for 1 week. You're on your own. But my own is not like that, though. My own is not like that. But me, let me just say, I love saving. And that has helped me. That's helped me grow more. So no one is going to tell you keep on. Jeez, no one is going to tell you keep on spending the money. In fact, your friends are going to help you. Those are the. In fact, school is full of fun. They're going to help you spend the money anyhow. They will help you. And if you are spending the money, in fact, if you spend it from me, because if I collect it from you, they will help you spend the money. But you see, when you're now struggling, like when you're now suffering, you're the only one that will eat that suffering. So please open your brain. If you are a new student, if you are just getting admission into the university, into any institution, just open your brain down. Then the third one is that, I said third one, I'm just saying third one. The next one is, nobody's going to tell you the insult, or what am I going to call it? Nobody's going to tell you the trauma you are going to pass through. Let me use trauma, because you see, these are our lecturers. Some of them, they are nice. Not all of them are wicked. Don't get me wrong. Not all of them are wicked, but some, if we go on anymore, they are the devil. Sorry. Don't say you had it from you. Some are the real devils. Why some? They are so nice. I've come in contact with a lot of lecturers. They are so nice. They are so wonderful. They are wonderful people. Why some? Jeez! If their lecture starts by 7 and you are not there by 6:58, 6:59, and you come in that 7 o'clock, go, you came that 7 o'clock. Is it come or came? Whatever. You are now in the hall. Like, you are not running towards the hall by that 7 o'clock. You got in front of the door like this. Forget it, you are not going to enter. That's some nature. But some of them will still pity you. Will still open the door for you. Don't do that next time you enter. That's all. So, they are not, nobody's going to tell you that you are going to pass through those 2 months. Okay. Ha, my own school. Jeez. See, if a student of Federal College of Education will share their book, just let me know in the comment section. Let's just, like, you just have fun. You just, oh my God. Like, you want to go and submit ordinary paper. They will insult you. There's no way you dress. Like, whether you dress fine, you dress like what would I even call it? You dress like an SU person. Your gown is floating on the floor like this, they will insult you. If you dress normal like this, there's nothing you like, there's nothing you do that will not get the attraction of those. But I don't know whether they are. I don't sincerely, I don't really know. I don't really know. I don't really know what to say again, sincerely. They will shall insult you, there's no way. So you should always have that at the back of your mind that people will insult you, they will insult you. You will come in fact, sometimes you will even be crying like this. Ah, God, what have I done? What have I done to earn this? What have I done? So just get your mind off it. It's fun. Very, very fun. Then, okay, let me kiss you. Let me just say small. In my own school, there's this funny attitude. Like maybe a lecturer or somebody wants to send you. You are the student and somebody. When I mean somebody, I mean somebody that is higher, like a staff. The school staff was. It's not even a lecturer. It might not be a lecturer. Are you getting it? Maybe you want to. The thing you want to submit is just in 2 blocks away from where you are. Are you getting me? Like they're not going to tell you that it's in 2 blocks. So they will say, go. Jesus, I'm going to do the school tour. Then you will see how my school the how will I even say it? The distance from each other. They will tell you, go. It's in that place. You have left the place. Why did you you shouldn't have even come this far. You should have been asking from if you are in office, if you don't know anywhere there. That's why they will just throw you come as one in school. So you will have to trek down to the school gate again. I've not had that experience really. I've not really had that experience. So, and I'm not saying I have it till I'm out. So they say I've come because I have asked this. For me, I've come because I have people that had that experience. So they will tell you go back to the main gate. Why are you coming here? Maybe from the main gate they direct you to the admin office. And they tell you what you want to, is in the where would they go? What are they even going to call it? I'm still going to remember. It's been a year, for me year like this, we've been at home, so I don't really remember the school this day again. So they tell you go back. You will now go back to that place again. They will not direct you again. Now go. Maybe you are fortunately for you on your way when you are going, you met a student that really know the in and out of the school. Then you are out of the trouble. But if you don't meet anybody, that means the wahala continues. So this thing is so funny. That means the wahala, the struggle continues, and you'll be walking up and down. When you are tired, I know that when you are tired, you can't stay in one place. Someone is so sure. So nobody is going to tell you the stress. Those stress you are going to pass through. Then the timing. See, no one is going to tell you that. Maybe now you're already packing your luggages. You're happy. Oh my God, I'm a student. Finally, I've got admitted. Jeez. It's a good thing, though. It's a very good, my dear brother, my dear sister. It's a very good thing. But nobody will tell you. Now, that's who you are going to. From Monday to Friday. How long do you see me? From Monday to Friday, you are going to be attending. If you see some people's timetable, my own timetable is still the last one we did. It also was Jesus. We do actually only go no. I don't really remember again whether we do have breaks. Maybe the breaks we have is 1 hour break in between 1 hour break. Not really that long. But immediately you leave your hostel or your accommodation wherever you're living. Immediately you leave by 7. Just forget it. Like just forget it for the whole day. Maybe I'm going to go back to that house or to the hostel by 7 again. So nobody's going to tell you all these experiences. I'm just sharing it with us too. Like, so I'm not, how would I say it? I'm not discouraging you. If you want to study, study. It is so, so interesting. Like, sometimes I'll just sit down and then I'll remember all those things and I'll just smile. I just smile. This is like, wow. The struggle of running from one hall to another. The struggle of, oh, stop shouting! The lecturers, you know? And then I'll just smile. I'll just smile. That's so, so interesting. That's so, so. Then nobody's going to tell you. Are you not like this? So, guys, well, there are so many frustrating things, though. Let me say the next one is like. No one will tell you the type of roommate you are going to live with, except you come from the same place. And when I even say the same place, somebody that are you living together in the same house in the first place? Except that. That is the only thing I can think you are. Because if you are living together, if you've been living with that person, then you will definitely know the attitude, the character of that person a little bit. But if you have not been living together, that means, oh my god, that is another wahala. Because you know it's going to tell you the type of true roommate you are going to live with. Like me now, from my 100 level days, I live in the hostel, in the school hostel. So, well, I don't choose my roommates. Like, I don't choose the type of, you don't even have the right, in my own school, you don't meet, like, because you don't even know the person that will be placed in the room you are located to. So you don't know them before, and you are just going to meet each other for the very first time. Oh my god. So when I was in 100 level, well, my roommates, they are sweet people. I've been living with sweet people right from 100 level. They are wonderful. They are wonderful set of people. There's no way we are not going to fight. Yes. There's no way you are not going to fight. If you are living in a room with somebody, definitely you will do something that person doesn't like. The person will also do something that you don't like. So you need to know that one. You people are going to fight. But in your fighting, like when you are fighting, you shouldn't let it become malice. Yes, you shouldn't let it become malice. Fight and settle it immediately. That's the real thing. That's the real deal. Don't say, hey, this one I can never talk to. For the whole semester, you don't talk with your roommates. What are you doing? What kind of person are you? For the whole semester, you are living in the same room. You don't talk with your roommates. Even if people come to check for you, they won't know, they won't have anything to say because you don't talk with the person. Actually, they won't know your whereabouts, they won't know anything about you. So it doesn't make sense. So these are the craziest things. Like you will live with some roommate and be like, ah, this one is so dirty. Oh jeez. I've actually lived with somebody that we used to talk. Like, she will make my hair for me. We do chat. We used to play ball. God, you know, everybody's not going to be alike. Oh, fingers. See my fingers. They're not equal. But you can actually make them to become equal. Like, I'm not saying go and be trimming your fingers. So, like, you can actually become equal with people you are living with when you try to blend with them. Blend positively. I'm not saying you should blend negatively. Blend positively. That's my roommate. She's the type that flares, you know. Now she's not like me. They will say, ah, this one. That's what they will say. This one. She's way barely no church, Marie, no fellowship. That's what they will say. This one. Oh, still no. You're already going to fellowship. You're already doing that. Yeah. So I'm not really that. I'm not with you. Well, that's the way I've been trained. Been trained that way. And I can't say because I get to school and now. Stray away from that way. No, it doesn't make sense. So, and then even in school, I have much time. Like, if there's any program 247, I can go if I wish to. Are you getting it? I can't really say that, hey, because I have too much time now. Every time I should not go and be sitting in church. No, there's time for everything. So, that my roommate is, you know, nah. That girl, it's like I never forget that. She's wonderful. But when it comes to cleaning, she's not that good. She's good, but she's not that good. So there was a night he actually fought. Like, I wasn't even really expecting it. I was so crazy. Like, I was just like, what is wrong with you? You have used this plate. Samyat. Ah, she was just looking at us that night. She was just looking at me then, like, ah, she can't even really. Kilo Shele gong gong. So I was just like, what is wrong with you? Kilo Shele, now we have used that place up to a week. You don't stay with us in this room. You will go, you will come back later. And the whole place is a mess. We are the one living in this room. Please go and clean it. Clean it tonight or else I'm going to throw it away. She thought I was joking. But little by little, the thing turned into argument. I was just like, let me just calm down. Because if people are hearing my voice, they'll be like, she's fighting, no. She's fighting. But eventually, I calmed down and then I call her. And she was like, hey, if they burn you, go and throw my face away. And that's what annoys me. That word annoys me. They burn you away. Go and throw it away. I will tell you that I don't have two fathers. It's just one father I have. So the thing is, I don't calm down. People were like, Stanley, calm down, calm down. I don't calm down. That one actually happened in 200 levels. So I don't calm down. And I calm down. And I'll call that. I don't like fighting. You know me. I don't like it when people are fighting. But this thing, let's just resolve it amicably. Please go and carry it. Please go and wash it. Please, I beg you in the name of God. Like, you don't... You're staying in this room with us, you are staying though, but you don't sleep with us here, not really every night. You don't really sleep with us here every night. So we are the one perceiving the odor. We are the one going through the struggle. Let me use that word. We are the one feeling it. You are not feeling it. You are you that you would have gone out since. You just be coming. You just carry your clothes and go again. So this is just one. Well. And then you see, Chejeli, she carried that cake. She went to Kinaman Kobukop, that's man for me, you know, this place that we used to fetch our water, which is this place that we used to fetch water. Well, she went to fetch water and then she came back, and that night she washed the whole place, she cleaned the her space, she cleaned everywhere, and then I was like, wow. This is good. If I had been so stubborn, to the extent of saying I will go and throw your plate out and I've gone ahead to throw a plate out, I don't know what would have happened that night. I don't really know. So sincerely, you don't know the type of roommates you are going to face. And then that same night, we cook. Sometimes I'll cook me. I like giving out food. So me, I don't like wasting food. If I know that this food I cook, I won't be able to finish it, I'll just give it out so that it won't waste, it won't end up in waste. I'll just give it out. So your elder will be praying for me rather than for your elder to be shaking for me. So we cook, we eat, and everybody, we watch movie on my phone, and then we slept. So that ends it. You don't know the type of roommate you are going to face. See, there are some roommates in my school, even if you are there. Even if you people are living together in the same room, if they make your year for you, they will collect their money. But that doesn't even happen during my own. I have two people that make share in my room when I was in children level. They helped me to make my year without collecting a dime. Even if when I don't know what to use, they will tell me, oh yeah, that one that you have used before, bring it out there. We'll use it to do another style. And that's it. And that's how we live. That's how. So your own, you might not have the opportunity I have. You might have some crazy roommates. That doesn't mean they are not good. They are not good on the other side. They are good. We are different from each other, so don't compare them to mine. Are you getting it? So nobody will tell you the type of roommates. Jeez, the type of roommates you are going to meet. Presently, these ones I'm going to be living with 300, but I don't know for now. I don't know anything about them. We've not really had that long, so I don't really know for now. But the ones I've come in contact with, the one we had lived together with, both in 100 level and in 200 level, they're wonderful people. So no one will tell you that. Like, seriously, no one will tell you. So what else? Nobody will tell you the type of lecturers they're going to be facing. Yeah, this one is so big. Nobody is going to tell you that these lecturers are going to be facing their streets, their discipline, they are good people, they are well behaved. Nobody will tell you. See, once you get to an institution, be careful. If you're a lady, even if you are not a lady, if you're a man, if you're a gentleman, be careful of people you like, you move with. Please be careful. No one will tell you the type of lecturer. There are some lecturers, they are prostitute incarnated. Let me use that word. They will always run whatever is under the skirt, or whatever. They always want to see what is under. So if you're a lady, use your brain. Use your brain. I've shared my own experience in one of my videos I made about sexual advances I got when I was in sexual advances I got as a student or something like that. I've made a video. Just go and watch it, then you will see some of the tips I some of the tips I use and how I overcome it. Go and watch it for your own good. So you are going to meet different kind of lecturers, sincerely. You are going to meet the street ones, you are going to meet the disciplined ones, you are going to meet the wonderful ones. Okay, I was talking about one lecturer at home one day. My aunt was like, "That man." Now she the person taught him. The person, there are two people, the husband and wife. I don't know his name. The person taught him. The person taught her when she was in school. That she mentioned the year that the person taught her. I said, "Eh? It's not. They are not. I'm not sure they are the one you are talking about because they are very nice people." She said, "Eh? Nice in one. Nice for wear." So that's life. That's life. So during your own year, they might be harsh, they might be strict, but during another person's year, they might be so nice because you have not really. Maybe you don't really move close to them that way. So nobody will tell you the kind of lecturers they are going to face. Are you getting? Nobody, no one will tell you. There are so many funny people, like so many funny experiences you have. So many funny experiences. Nobody's going to tell you to read for exam. Nobody, if you like read, if you like be sleeping. That's your own. Nobody will tell you. Read though, time to read for exam. Nobody will tell you. Nobody will tell you that you are going to be facing a lot of impromptu tests, the tests you did not prepare for. That's why you need to read daily. You need to read daily. God will help all of us. So nobody will tell you all those things. I think I'm done. I think that's all. I think that's all. That's all. That's all. Is there anything else? 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 Done. So, guys, with this, well, let me just say with this. I'm going to be updating you about the new ones that I come in contact with maybe later, Sha. So, I'll be updating you. Let me just say this one will be part one. So, please and please, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please do so. Subscribe. Hit that notification bell, turn it on so that you get notified anytime I post any video. Thank you. God bless you. With this, I've come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Bye.